Well, let's get back to the impact climate change is having on our health. And joining us now in studio is Dr. SRINATH REDDY, who's the president of the Public Health Foundation of India. Thank you so much for being here with us. Mm-hmm. Now, when we talk about climate change, one of the issues here in India especially is the rising temperatures. We've seen, heat waves. 2016 was one of the hottest years we've seen. And talk about the impact that increasing temperatures is having on our health.
Well, heat waves cause a lot of heat stress in the body. And then they can kill through heat strokes, heat exhaustion, and a variety of other health effects, particularly on the heart and the circulatory systems, on the kidney, etc. And we have seen many number of heat-related deaths, but then they're not adequately quantified because the cause of death is usually described as because of some particular disease, and heat is not actually the one that appears on the death certificate. Some of my colleagues in Ahmedabad actually did a good study in 2011 where they quantified the excess mortality in the month of May as compared to the preceding year and the year subsequently when there was a period of heat spike. And there was a 43% excess mortality from all-cause mortality. That was the increase in the deaths. And of course, later on, by adopting a heat action plan, the city of Ahmedabad actually managed to control the deaths in subsequent heat spikes in the next few years. But all across India, we have been seeing...
And this action plan?
This heat action plan actually has helped to reduce the mortality during these heat spikes. And this is now being adopted by the city of Nagpur, Bhubaneswar, and the National Disaster Management Authority is now planning
is
to
it
scale...
Is about creating more awareness and informing people?
No, actually, heat shelters, more availability of water, and also ensuring that the kind of... the building and construction is also altered in order to make sure that there is less exposure to heat. But most important is for people who are working outdoors, the poor, the agricultural labor, the daily wage worker. They are the ones who are most impacted. And you need to create some opportunity for them to get heat shelters, water and others, so that they are not succumbing to it. But we have seen this happening in Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, Central India. Everywhere now we are seeing many more heat-related deaths being reported as a result of these heat spikes.
And we're probably going to be seeing more of this in years to come, given that we're seeing increasing temperatures.
So we do need climate mitigation in order to make sure that we reduce this kind of heat spikes. But at the same time, we need adaptation as well through appropriate heat action plans.
Right. Adaptation, I think, is the key over here. Can you also discuss the impact that climate change crisis, that, you know, the way it's impacting cardiovascular health as well?
Well, firstly, because of excess heat, the blood supply gets diverted from the central circulation to the peripheral circulation because the blood vessels dilate. That means the heart is under greater stress to pump more blood for the body. So there is overall a period of circulatory failure that happens and death can result. But also the thickness of blood increases, the viscosity increases. So much more likely to get clotting episodes. So heart attacks, acute coronary events, brain strokes, these are becoming increasingly common with exposure to heat. At the same time, because of water deprivation, because you're getting dehydrated as well, so that increases the blood thickness, but it can also cause acute kidney injury, which itself aggravates multisystem failure. So the overall circulatory system is becoming a problem. And even if you have, for example, vector-borne diseases like dengue or other diseases, it's been very clearly shown that people who have a pre-existing cardiac ailment are much more likely to die. So firstly, it does kill people with pre-existing cardiac events, even because of the direct heat effect. But even the infectious diseases are more likely to claim people with a pre-existing heart disease. So cardiovascular effects are going to be both direct as well as mediated through other effects.
All right, now along with the extreme temperatures and this impact that they're having on our health, what other impacts on health from climate change do you see?
Well, there is also a major issue of what we do not usually attribute directly to health. The whole issue of agriculture and food security, we find that rice, wheat, potatoes, and pulses, all of these are going, and fruit and vegetables, all of them are going to be decreased both in terms of yield as well as in terms of nutrient quality. You're going to see a 6 to 10% decrease in the actual yield of staples with even 1 degree centigrade.
Output is going to go.
The nutrient quality is going to go down. The iron, zinc, vitamin C, all of the content of this is going to go down. So net result is you're going
and
to see...
And that's a result of climate change.
Yes.
That nutrition value of the food will
absolutely,
also go down.
Absolutely, absolutely. So the yield and the quality will go down. And therefore, we are going to see many more nutritional effects. Already, we are having a bit of challenge about childhood malnutrition. And over that, you superimpose a nutrition security challenge.
Hmm.
Then you're going to have the poor and the vulnerable even more victimized by climate change and the impact on food and agriculture. Fisheries. Now, you find that because of rising seawater levels and increasing salinity of even fresh water, you're finding that fish yield is coming down. In Sundarbans, people in the coastal areas are actually retreating into an interior because their rice fields are not producing rice now. Their fish ponds are contaminated because of increasing salinity. And their families are suffering poverty and malnutrition.
Rising sea levels as well there in the Sundarbans because of climate change.
And in fact, in Bangladesh also...
Islands are getting smaller and smaller.
Yeah, in Bangladesh also the same thing has been reported. The nutritional impact of climate change because of the impact on food and agriculture systems is again something that impacts on health, both in the immediate term as well as over a longer period.
All right. So what is the medical community? How can the medical community work to inform people better and help them deal with these crises that are emerging?
Well, I think it's very important for us to recognize that the Paris Agreement itself said there is a right to health. And universal health coverage also is ultimately going to be hinged on the right to health. So the medical community should be able to, first of all, try and build a climate resilient health system so that even during climate challenges, natural disasters, extreme weather events, we are able to provide care for the people in emergencies. But much more importantly, we must recognize what the problems are because of climate change and try and educate people as trusted messengers of health. At the same time, we must become concerned citizens and advocate both for mitigation and adaptation. And we must also ensure that our health facilities are much more smart and climate smart. But even simple messages, for example, you are asking about cardiovascular effects.
Yes.
Some of the delayed effects, let us say, or even immediate effects for that matter. If it's very hot, I can't be physically active. And that in turn impacts upon my risk of heart disease. So there are so many important elements of health messaging that we ought to be able to give to policymakers as well as to people. But the most important thing is climate change makes you very vulnerable in terms of health. While the health system and the doctors must do everything to build a climate resilient health system and provide messaging to policymakers and the public alike, it is absolutely important for us to become also advocates for change so that policymakers and the public alike take this issue much more seriously
right.
because the human impact is going to be very grave.